I'm genuinely super excited to be making this video because we're talking about design patterns in React once again, and you guys seem to really love this topic. These videos tend to do really well on my channel, and the design pattern that I have for you today is something that, although you're not going to use in every single React application that you work on, when you do have to use it, and when it solves a problem that you actually have to get solved, the way that it solves it is pure magic, and it's honestly just beautiful. Of course, you've seen the title, you know what we're talking about. We're talking about the compound component design pattern in React. And by the way, before we jump into it, if you're watching this video, chances are you're interested in learning about React, which is great because I have Project React, which is a course where you literally build a big and complex application with React, and I walk you through the entire process every step of the way from A to Z. You literally don't need to know anything about React. Everything that you have to know will be taught in the course, and I'm literally showing you how to build a big and complex application in a way that's super accessible to a total beginner. If you're interested, it'll be the first link in the description. It's called Project React. I highly, highly recommend it. All right, cool. So let's begin. Here, I have a simple application running. We have the app component, and this is rendering one single component, the postcard component, and we're passing it an actual post. It has an ID, has a title, has a content, and it also has a user. The postcard component is defined over here, and yes, we are working in TypeScript, so the first thing that you're going to see in bright yellow or orange is going to be the types, which I really love. So we have here the type of the post, so we have ID, title, content, user, and then we have the type of the component, its props, its postcard props, it's receiving a post, which is of type post, and you can see here the post, and we're using the post to essentially render out some actual UI for that specific post. This is what the application looks like, so we have our post over here, we have the title, we have the content, we have the author over here, and then we have two buttons, which you can imagine would do something really, really cool, but because we are working in a simple video tutorial, obviously they do nothing, they have no actual functions attached to them, and that's totally fine. So this is your traditional, very simple React component. There's nothing really fancy about it. It's just a component that receives some props, and then it doesn't even have state or any other logic to it. It just takes those props and actually renders out some actual JSX to actually render out on the screen. This is a very simple component. And then over here in the app component, I want you to think about this component as one single screen in our application. So maybe instead of app, we can do something like home feed. And then screen like so. This is going to be the actual home feed screen, the screen that if this was a social media application or a blog or whatever, you would see a feed of all of the posts, right? That's what you would see here. Currently, we only have one post, but you can imagine if we had multiple posts, we would show all of them here. I really want you to think of this component as that screen because I want you not to think about the fact, what would we do if we wanted to show this postcard on another screen, but show it slightly differently than the way that we show it over here? Because that's something that can happen, right, in a real application. You might be working on an application and you have one screen and you're showing one type of entity, you're showing the post in this case, and then you wanna have the profile screen and maybe show only that specific user that you're on the profile of, only their posts, and in that screen, you wanna do something different. Maybe you don't wanna show all of these buttons over here, or maybe you don't wanna show the author over here, or you wanna do something else with the author, you might wanna put it at the top of the component. How would you do that, given the fact that you only have this one postcard component here? How would you allow this to basically have two different views on two different screens while still looking at the same exact post, the same exact props that were being passed to it? Well, one naive way to do it is you could add a prop over here and you can say is on profile and then make this optional and make this a boolean and then have this go here is on profile. And then based off of this prop, you might do something. For example, you might not want to show the username if we are on the profile, right? So we could do something like is not on profile and end, and then we're gonna put this paragraph tag over here. So now, if we actually say that, let's say for example, we're on the profile screen and we're gonna say is on profile, now if you go back here to our application, you're gonna see that the author is no longer shown, right? We've essentially achieved what we wanted to. If we're on the home screen, on the home feed screen, we're not gonna pass this. If we're on the profile screen, we are gonna pass this, and then this component is going to know how to do that. Now, while it's cool that this works and this kind of solves our problem, right? We can have this component and it's reusable enough that we can use it in two different places and it works through this prop. But now what happens if we have a third screen? Maybe this is your favorite screen or a place where you can save all of your posts. And on that screen, we wanna show something different once again that is different from the homepage or the profile screen. How would we do that in that case? Because now we have three screens that we wanna show the same component, show the same post, but have slightly different properties. Well, if you're thinking to do something like is on saved, screen and then do this Boolean and then put this here as well. I highly recommend that you do not do this because now this is going to get extremely complicated. Now you have combinations of props. So now here you have to determine if you're showing the user.name, and let's say that, for example, you want to show it on the profile. You don't want to show it on the profile, but you want to show it if it's on a saved screen, but only if this case is true, then you're going to have such a big mess inside of this component that is not going to be maintainable. It's not going to be readable, and you're going to have a hard time trying to make this component fit every single possible use case that your application might have now, or even worse, might have in the future, which you can't predict. So doing it this way is not the way to go. I would highly recommend against it. And actually, let's come here and let's remove all of this work that we did. And also, let's remove the isOnProfile, because also we're not going to need to use this. There is actually a much better solution that we can implement to solve this problem in a much more elegant way that's a lot simpler and a lot easier to maintain. And that is by applying the concept, the design pattern of compound components in React. So compound components, the only difference that they have to a normal simple component like this is that they are components that are split up into multiple components, into subcomponents that are all designed to work together and to not be applicable anywhere else. These subcomponents essentially all make up one whole, one main component that can be used anywhere in the application. But the beauty of it is that you are completely free to pick and choose which subcomponents you want to use in that specific use case, and even more importantly, in which order that you want to use them. And you can customize them further if you want. That is going to allow this component to be broken up into multiple of its subparts, and then whoever wants to use them, the caller of that, in that case the home feed screen or any other screen, can just import and use only the specific components that they want for that specific view, for that specific screen, and have everything work together in a really elegant way. So let me show you how that would work and how we would do that inside of our component over here. So first, let's get rid of this isOnProfile because we're not going to need it. And now we're going to come back to Postcard and we want to convert this into a compound component. So what we're going to do is, because this postcard over here receives a post, we're actually going to make use of the React Context API. We're going to create a context for this. We're going to store the post inside of that context. And then we're going to make that context available to all of the subcomponents of Postcard. Now, what are the subcomponents of Postcard? Because if you look at this component over here at this JSX, we're only rendering one component. So how can we split this up? Well, if you look at the actual contents of this JSX, we have multiple sections here that we can make into multiple subcomponents. We have the title over here, which can be its own component. We have the content, which can be its own component. We have this author section over here, which again can be its own component. And we also have the buttons over here, which also can be its own subcomponent. What we're essentially trying to do is we're trying to look at this postcard component and we're trying to see what are its different sections. How can we split it up so that whenever we're using this, we can pick and choose the sections that we want to apply on that specific view, right? So if you don't want to show the title for that, we're just not going to use the post title component. If we don't want to show the content, we're just not going to use the content. We can do this for every single section because we've made this into a subcomponent that is all part of the main postcard component. And then if you look here, every single one of these sections over here is going to need to have access to the actual post. We're doing post.title here. We're doing post.content, post.user.name. So instead of actually passing the post around to all of these components as we're using them, that's why we're going to create a context. We're going to store this post inside of the context. And then these components over here, these subcomponents, are going to be able to use that context, use the post, and then they're going to be able to have all of the data to actually render out what they want to render. So let's now do this, and let me walk you through step by step on how we convert this into a compound component. So the first thing that we're going to want to do is start creating our context. So first, because we are working in TypeScript, I'm going to create the actual type of our context. So we're going to do type postcard context is going to be equal to, we're just going to do post and then post like so, and that is going to be our postcard context. Then we're going to come here, we're going to do const postcard context. That is going to be equal to create context. We're going to import this text from React. There we go. We're going to give this a type, postcard context or undefined, right? If you're unfamiliar with how context works, I do have a whole tutorial video on context that you can watch to get yourself up to speed. But essentially, this is how you create that actual context. Then we're going to come here to our main postcard component, and we're just going to wrap everything inside of the provider of that context. So we're going to come here and do postcard context.provider. We're going to pass it here the post as a value, which again, this is the type that it expects. So this is going to work. And then we're just going to close here the tag of our context, and we're going to do postcard context provider like so. Now, everything that is inside of here can actually use the context and can get access to the post without having to receive the post directly through props. After that, let's now create subcomponents for all of these different sections, and let's attach them to the main postcard component. And the way that we do that is we're going to come here, and let's start first with the title over here. So we're going to do postcard.title. And what we're doing here is we're essentially going to add a function over here, a component, and we're going to attach it to postcard.title, which is going to mean that in this component here, all that we have to do is import postcard. And then if we want to use the postcard title, we can just do postcard.title, and that is going to give us access to this component that we're just going to create right now. And this is going to be a very handy way to not have to import all of these components and just use them directly from the postcard. So we're going to do this function and then postcard title like this. And over here, the only thing that we're going to do is we're just going to render out this thing over here, this section over here, post.title with the H1. So we're going to return, and then we're just going to paste this over here. Now we have a problem. We need a post over here, right? So that's why we created the context. The alternative to the context would be to have this define some props and then have this receive a post as props, which meant that if we were to use this inside of a component, we would have to pass the post to every single one of these subcomponents. We don't want to do that. So that's why we created this context over here that we're going to use through the use context hook. So first, let's close this because we actually have a mistake. And now instead of directly accessing the context, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to create a custom hook over here. Again, watch my context tutorial video to actually understand why we're doing this to make it easier for us to actually access this postcard context. So I'm going to do function use postcard context. That is going to be a function that is going to, let's see if Copilot can do it. There we go. It's going to use the use context hook right here from React, and is going to try to access the actual context. And if the context is undefined, it's going to throw an error, and then it's going to return to us the context. The reason why we're doing this is because we actually want to prevent any of these components from being used outside of the postcard. We're going to require that each of these components is put as a child of postcard because they have to. They need to access this post variable, which is only going to be available through that specific postcard context. And by using this custom hook instead that we defined over here, we can actually use this instead of just calling use context directly. And this will check for us if we have an error, which means that we're not inside of the child of this provider over here. And that is going to effectively prevent by throwing an error from using this component over here without using the main postcard component. That's why we're doing this. So now with this hook, we can just come here and actually use it. So we can do const and then post equals use postcard context like so. And now we have access to the post over here, and we have post.title like so. This is great. We can now remove this from this actual component. Now, the next steps for us to do is to basically do the same thing for all of these different sections over here. So let's do one for the content. We're going to do postcard content. Let's see, can Copilot do it? There we go. It can. We're going to do one for the user.name. So let's see what Copilot does. Postcard.user, there we go. And is this going to be the same? Let's copy this entire thing exactly as it was, just to make sure that we didn't lose any information. And finally, we're going to need, let's see, Copilot, can you come to the rescue? Postcard.buttons. And let's say postcard buttons, let's see what it does. And there we go, it knows to do those buttons. And now we've used AI to essentially save us a little bit of work and just not have to repeat ourselves again. Then what we have to do is come here and remove all of this. And then we just have to actually get children to allow this component to pass all of these subcomponents as children. And they're all just going to be rendered over here. And the reason why we want to use children is because we want to keep these styles over here, right? These are styles that should be applicable to any postcard, regardless of which subcomponents you use. And for that reason, we're going to keep this div over here, and we're going to put children over here to actually allow this to be passed any children. And for this to have access to children, we need to do props with children like so. And here we're just going to do children. And I'm going to save, and there we go. And now we've effectively converted postcard from a static simple component to a compound component, and we can use all of these subparts inside of any view. So let's come here and see we have our postcard over here. We have the post. Now, if I go back to the application, you're going to see that we have nothing besides the wrapper styles, these styles over here that actually set some width and background colors and padding and whatnot. That is what you're seeing here very faintly because we haven't used any of these subcomponents. To use the subcomponents, all that we have to do is come in here and actually pass children. So first let's close the postcard, and then all that we can do is postcard.title. And see, the beauty of this is that now TypeScript actually knows that this is a component that we can use. So we can actually just pass postcard.title, and now look at that. We actually have the title that is coming directly from the actual post. It is this title over here that this component is getting through context. That is the magic of a compound component. And then we can do the same thing for all of these other components. We can do postcard.content, right? We can close, do this like this. We can do postcard.user, and we can do postcard.buttons like so, and have all of these components over here. And now we have the same post as we had before, but through a compound component. And the beauty of this is that now we can actually customize this. We can reorder this. We can actually remove the user and not have it show up. And this works, the user is gone. We can choose to also reorder the content and the title if we wanted to do that. And now the content is at the first position and the title is at the second. And we can choose to remove the buttons again to not show them. And now we have the same postcard component using the same data, but it's completely customizable in any way that you want, which means that we can have any new page. We can have the profile page. We can have the saved page. We can have any page. We can just use this component and plug and play the pieces that we want. Even better, we can also have these components, each one of them, because they're separate components, taking props to further customize them. Let's say that, for example, we wanted to add styles to this title. We can add a style prop over here, a class name, and pass some table and classes to this actual component if we wanted to. Right, doing it this way, you have complete customization, and you can put this component in any different view that you want and have it still work with the core functionality. If you had some functionality to update a post, you would put it inside of this component. That way, you don't have to repeat yourself every single time, and you can have as many different views of the same thing as you want. That is when you want to use something like compound components. Now, you have to be honest, this is kind of cool, right? We created a component, we created subcomponents, everything works, it's type safe, everything is compartmentalized, and we can use and plug and play which ones we want. You might be thinking, well, shouldn't we do this for every single component that we have in our React application? And the truth is, you shouldn't. You should only use this whenever you have a component that you want to show the same thing on multiple screens with subtle differences between the different views that you're showing the thing in. Because really, if you look at this component is so much bigger and there's so much more code than we had initially, just because we want to make this into a compound component. We have to extract everything in a subcomponent. We have to create a whole context for this and a whole custom hook just to make this work. And usually for most components in most use cases, this is not worth it. This is only worth it, again, if you have a view, if you have a component that you want to show the same thing in different places, but you want to have those things be customizable without having to create either two copies of the same component, or even worse, having props and mixing everything up and just putting all of the logic in a jumble mumble super big mess. If you're in a situation where compound components make sense, definitely use them. Now you know exactly how to do them. And this is a great design pattern to apply to your own React applications. And this is something that I've started doing in my own React applications. Where it makes sense, I do this. And honestly, it's magical. It really solves the problem super nicely. And now you know as well how to do it. If you enjoyed this video and you want to see more videos just like this one, make sure to leave it a big thumbs up. You can also click here to subscribe, or you can click here to watch a different video of mine that YouTube seems to think that you're really going to enjoy. And with that being said, my name has been Darius Kozdan. This is Kozdan Solutions. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Ciao, ciao.